Okay, this is the system that we have already set up. Under the DSP software, we have the two individual tweeters here, which is already tuned for a response. And then we will have the mids, the two mids in the doors, on the doors. And this is the response that has been tuned for the mids. And then we also have the rear speakers, but the rear speakers is not so critical. So we have just eliminated the bass from the rear speakers and just let it roll off on its own. And then we also have the subwoofer, the two subwoofers on the front of the car where it's at the passenger footwell. So what this system will be better than the original system is, even if we play it loud, you will hear that the vocals are clear, does not break up, as well as if you speak to someone else inside the car, you can still hear the other person speak. So the system is very linear and does not have any peaks at all, okay? And I will play something with bass now. Then the other thing that we have done actually is to use time delay, where the center of the vocals will come out right in the center below the rear view mirror. And this is where the time delay comes in. For the tweeter, we have a time delay here. And also for the mids, we have a separate time delay here. This is what allows us to give us the center vocals here, okay? You will see that the tweeters have got a dip here. This is very typical because the tweeters are high up here, and if we don't do any dips here, it will be too bright, all right, and it will not give us that natural sound. And then even on the vocals, there will be dips here where it gives us a much smoother sound to match up with the tweeters. This is why the tuning, the DSP, is so important. It allows us to tune it so that we can get a very smooth and clear sound. And even if we play it loud, it will not sound fatiguing, all right? You can hear the tweeters. You can hear the tweeters. They are not super sharp, but yet just nice to balance off with the vocals and also the bass. Basically, with the DSP, this is what you can expect to get, lah. Much improved, clear and consistent vocals throughout the range. I'm only just playing a normal USB track here, but if you all want to have a listen, you can play your other Bluetooth music and all that. It will sound very, very linear. If the installer tunes the DSP correctly, okay, in the car, most of the genres of music, be it classical, rock music, R&B, hip hop, pure vocals, it should sound very good. Most shops, what they tune is they tune for preset A, they will use it for maybe heavy bass. Preset B is for vocals, and you need to switch between A and B, because that's very simple to tune. Because if you got preset A, it's more for bass, they just up the bass setting and they don't take care of some of the bass settings disturbing the vocals, and hence they just use preset A. And they will use preset B for vocals, they bring down the bass, all right? But if it's a good tuning, you will find that just one preset, okay, just preset A, it will satisfy all types of music that you listen to. If it doesn't, then the tuning needs to be tweaked so that it will suit most of the genres of music. Now, however, the bass part, some people like the bass a bit more heavier. Some people like the bass not so heavy, okay? Now the bass part, we don't need a preset to tune it, because if you get an undersea woofer or you get an outboard subwoofer, you can actually use the controller to tune. They have a little knob for you to adjust the bass level. Or you can even go into your player where the bass setting, you bring it down 1-2 notches or bring it up 1-2 notches and you should be good already. You will get that level of bass coming in or going out. Okay, that is what you will get now. But the treble, if it's too sharp, initial tune, if you bring it down, it will be too muddy. So the installer needs to tune it just nice where the tweeter is not too bright but yet still gives you the feel of that sharp sound. And this is the differentiation between a good tune and a normal tune.
I would definitely recommend these speakers for your W205 Mercedes-Benz. And first is because it's a plug and play, so it doesn't void my warranty. There's also the option to have a center speaker installed to create that centered stage in the car without the help of any aftermarket amplifier such as the one that I have, which is the Audison AP-F8.9-bit. This set of speakers, it gave me an eargasm from the pleasure of having a high-end audio system. I was really wowed by the bass and vocal clarity. That was when I realized that I had been short-changed by the lack of details, especially when I compared it to my original speakers. So if you own a W205 Mercedes, these are the speakers for you. And then it-